You're putting a chunk of Lauren out in the world. That sounds terrible and has to go down as like my worst analogy.
I do that every morning, 20 minutes after a cup of tea. No. Sorry.
That just became the promo for this.
Just regular. It's great.
This whole event's been brought to you by Metamucil.
When your band is launched by the internet, should you have to put up with the internet's standard barrage of sexism? That is the question that Lauren Mayberry from the Scottish band CHVRCHES has been tackling ever since they hit the international scene. Alongside the accolades and the sold-out shows has also come a steady stream of misogyny and threats. And so when we sat down together at the Splendour in the Grass 2018 forum, we talked music, Joan of Arc, and why female musicians shouldn't have to put up with it.
But I wanted to ask you about an encounter you had where a producer made you watch Joan of Arc.
He did, yes. The Mila Jovovich version.
So why did a producer want you to watch Mila Jovovich giving a big anthemic sort of speech? What was that going to give you?
Well, it was a guy called Dave Stewart from the Eurythmics, a band that people might have heard of. It was the first day that we had met him. And it was like at 6 o'clock every day, apparently, he makes a martini. So he was like, guys, have some martinis. And we're like, And he was like, incidentally, I've queued up this scene. The screen came down. And he was like, I want you to watch that and like think about whether you're trying hard enough. And I was like, what?
What? That's a little bit... Passag?
Well, just and then I was like, that's offensive. I'm definitely trying hard enough. What do you mean? But then at the end of it, he was like, well, you're trying like 70%. And then he said, it seems to me that you want to be like a punk rock Joan of Arc of pop music. So just do it and stop complaining about it. And I was like, oh.
And what did you take away from that out of curiosity?
Well, after I was like... done crying or whatever. I don't know. I thought like a lot of the performance stuff is pretending to be those things. It's pretending to be like 100 times. What is that? That's a spider.
Oh, it's
in
a
Australia.
Spider.
What kind? Oh, you just killed it. You didn't even know what one it was.
It's Australia. You killed them.
I thought there was...
No.
What's the one? What
we'll
was that?
Never
that was
know.
Just a little brown one. We don't know. And now it's smeared.
So, fun well. Fact, I'm completely colorblind, so as a reflex, I just killed them all.
All right, you were like punk rock Joan of Arc of killing insects.
And that was how I injected my personality into this moment.
But it kind of fits. We're like, you're just, you know, you're being 120% yourself, just killing shit.
Yeah. I used to have a boss that would always say to us at the beginning, we were working on a TV show, and when we started the TV show, he said, all of you just need to be aggressively you. Sounded great, but in practice you're like, what does that even mean? But I guess the same thing applies at that moment. What do you do with that advice, with that interpretation of you?
Yeah, well, I feel like I can apply it to like the performance part of the band. When I was growing up or whatever, I was never the person that was like, in the center of the room being like, look at me. So, stupid job choice.
Terrible. You've made a series of terrible life choices.
And then I guess when he said that, I was like, yeah, you should always be pushing yourself.
Before music, you did a master's.
Yeah. Whoa, you did your research.
I have my moments. And I'm going to see if I can remember it by heart. Images of femininity in women's magazines.
That was my boring thesis, yes.
Yeah. But what I'm curious about is, having spent a lot of time researching and thinking about it, and then suddenly being in a position where you are being photographed and you're being put in photo shoots, what are the rules about how I do and don't want to be represented?
Well, I think when we first started, people thought that, well, maybe this is my projection, but it seemed like people thought I was being really uptight or really like overly conscious about stuff. And I definitely was working a lot out of fear, which I don't know is great, but in hindsight, I'm like, well, I'm kind of glad we were conscious of trying to say no to certain things just so you set the precedent, because I think it's hard to put that genie back in the bottle after it's come out. Like there's, I'm not going to say what magazine it is, but has been rebranded, and then they keep being like, do you guys want to like be interviewed for this magazine? The guys can't come. I'm like, oh, they're like, it's a men's lifestyle magazine now. I'm like, a spade is a spade. I don't care what cover you put on it. Like years and years of disgusting shit. It's not like obliterated because you were like, no, we changed it because it wasn't selling.
But, please tell me you actually said that. I want to be
well,
in that
I say
conversation.
That to, I say that to our manager who's just like, she's not available.
There's a world of people out there that think that when a musician gets up and has an opinion about something other than music, Yeah, just play the hits. You're a musician. You're not entitled to have an opinion on the world, on politics. If that person was sitting in front of you, what would you say to that person?
I kind of wonder what people think songs are written about, you know? I don't mean that in a sarcastic way. I just mean like songs are thoughts and feelings about your life, about the world, about people you know, about things that you see. And I guess people are like, well, if you're that sensitive, you shouldn't be in this job. And I'm like, well, I don't know. I think there's a difference between people being like, oh, that record sucks, and someone being like, hey, I'm going to rape you. I'm like, whoa, one
That's
of these
a,
is
a very like, big, what? Defined what? Junk.
And then when people are like, if you've got, you don't have thick enough skin, you shouldn't be in a band. I'm like, excuse me? What other job is this? Like, is that an appropriate response?
Why do you think people have that opinion?
It was a woman that said that. I remember it. Shouldn't be in a pop band if you don't want to take that. And then I was like, it's kind of extra sad because I was like, oh, then you've just... I think we all do that. You internalize the messages that are put out to you. And in that moment, I was like, you've just soaked up this misogynist culture. And I definitely... You know, there's things where you realize... What you're like, oh, why do I want to do that? Oh, because like this is where how we've grown up and this is what we think is real and normal.
I'm in misery where you can seem as old as your omens, and the mother we share will never keep your proud head from falling.
If you could change anything about the way we talk about women in pop music, what would you change?
The fact that we separate it into women and pop music.
Yeah.
I don't want to be a downer or whatever, but I'm kind of confident that there's never going to be a time in my creative career where I will be talked about in any way without a gender prefix on it. Like, that's always, you know, at least now when people talk to our band about it, we have a more constructive conversation.
Yeah.
But even from the beginning of the band, all the questions were gendered. Even if you look at the way people write about the band, they're never like, Martin and Ian are frolicking around the stage, flaunting their arms in black t-shirts. It's always like wispy voiced and elven or diminutive, and you know, they're short too. No one calls them diminutive.
Hey, Lauren, thank you so much for sitting down with us.
Yeah, thank you guys for coming. Thanks for having me.
And enjoy the rest of your Splendour.